much dwell on what I was and in the past.
How are you doing now?
I don't know. I'm alive. I'm able to take care of my house and my kids and all that stuff. I'm pretty happy, you know, but like in that situation in the past when I had these hundreds of millions of dollars, I had so much I couldn't even do so little. There's nothing I can do. Right now I have so little, but I do so much, you know. My objectives are different and agendas are totally different than it was when I was younger and plus when I was fighting.
And interestingly, along those lines, obviously few people in this world ever attain the kind of wealth that you enjoyed. How satisfying was it, though?
It's like the drugs. You might as well say you have it all, but it's still that empty hole that you're trying to fulfill. That's an interesting subject. It's just you spend as much as you can to try to get that satisfaction, fulfill that hole. It just is bottomless.
And what was that hole that you were trying to fill for you?
I don't know what it was. You know, I don't know. Sometimes I'm in now, I say to myself, what was that all about? What was that period all about? You know, what was the late 90s? What was that all about? What was I angry about? What was I depressed about? What was I seeing all these? What was that all about? What was that ear button? What was all that stuff all about back there? What was wrong with me, you know?
Has that hole been fulfilled now, or do you still find yourself trying to look to fill it?
I don't know what I want, but I know I don't want what I already had.
For more clips from this interview, visit GrahamBensinger.com.
People helped me when I was in need, so I know if everybody can do something small, it can make just a world of difference.
The Hangover movies, your fondest memory from shooting the first Hangover and your fondest memory from shooting the second Hangover?
Just that the first Hangover, the guys just had my back so much, you know what I mean? They carried me real good to make sure, you know, I was a meth, I was overweight, 380 pounds. I was a pig, high on cocaine, and they had to know I was messed up. I couldn't even talk. You know, I had the cocaine talk when the dog.
Really?
Yeah. So those guys are just beautiful people. They were just beautiful. They had my back, you know. I appreciate that and stuff. Then they asked me to come back, and I could just never be thankful to Todd Phillip and those guys. They were just really good people, and they just gave me that, you know.
Boxing legend Iron Mike Tyson wasn't the tallest fighter, but one of his strongest weapons was the short hook. We're here with boxing trainer, fitness expert Brandon Krause. Tell us about the short hook.
You know, terrific short punches on the inside from Iron Mike. Tony Zale had a great short hook to the head that he would set up via body shot. And you go throughout history, you know, a lot of top guys, guess what, had a great inside game as well. You know, and you want to think of them as completely separate. On the outside, in my boxing world, in my mathematical world, I set things up via jab distance. I try to fill that distance with other long punches. I try to time my opponent. I use my movement. I use the majority of my straight shots, and I come with that hook every now and then. I come with a body shot every now and then. When I'm really on that boxing game, I'm primarily working on those straight shots. Now, when I allow my opponent to get closer to me, or when he works his way closer to me, I have to fight with him in more of a short range of attack or a short game of attack. And they're completely different. You know, the way that you generate this power is different. The punches that are available to you are different, right? When I got a guy out here on the end of my jab, you know, maybe I can pump the right hand on him, set up a longer left hook, come off of it. Maybe I can step that foot in here off the jab and hook off it.
Oh, hold on one second. Let's bring a body.
Art, will you come here for a second?
Okay.
So here's Art, who's much taller than me, right? And
uh-huh.
If I was boxing on the outside and he had me on the end of his jab, I would be forced to have to come with long-range shots in order to match him at this range. But that would be silly, because he's naturally taller than me anyway.
He'll keep you on the outside.
He's going to be a lot better at the outside game than I am. Now, if I can get inside on Art and really close the distance, and when I say close range, guys, I'm talking close. I'm talking like chest to chest, or hip to hip, as I like to say. I got to generate power on my hooks, but I cannot keep the range of motion great. So how do I do that is I rely a hell of a lot more on my hips and my body. And I basically just put these in a punching position, and then my hip is what's driven here. So Art's on the end of my jab, and like I said before, I can pump the right hand at him and then turn left hook when there's a great amount of distance, right? When I'm close, what I need to do is snap my hip as hard as I can, and this fist and my shoulder really are not going to move all that much, and I get that power. You can see here I got my hand on my hip, so you can see how much more my hip moves
okay.
than my fist. And then when I'm on the outside, it's kind of the reverse happens. My fist doesn't end up moving, my hip doesn't end up moving as far as my fist when I have room to snap it.